brought up an interesting point about how your show has really helped improve the reputation of an office that had been troubled before. I just wondered if you could take off on that.
Right. I mean, I think that was one of the positive aspects of doing the TV show, and the county knew it. That we knew that, you know, by being transparent in how we do our cases and how we think, that would see how the morgue functioned, and that would change the reputation. Because when I took over, there was some troubled times in the morgue, justified or not. And then people that were actually working in the morgue told me that they felt embarrassed to work there because some of the things that were being said about the office. And so when we started doing the show, it was a really quick way to change that reputation, because we are what we are, and you see it on TV, and people can see that we try to do a good job.
And now you feel like it's palpable that the people who work for you take pride in the fact that they do.
Oh, I think the people that work at the morgue are very proud they work at the morgue. They know that we care about quality, they know that other people know we care about quality, and I think they get a little bit of satisfaction when people ask them, do you work for Dr. G?
That's cool. You made a point of saying up there that you are probably the only person in this hemisphere who hasn't talked about Caylee Anthony. Obviously, you may be right. But in terms of, like, any inside baseball, when you had to do that particular autopsy, were there any extraordinary security measures that were taken, or just any kind of an inside baseball story that's not talking about the case specifically, but rather just your experience with having to do that? Did you feel the pressure? Was it an
No, I didn't, you know, it's... That's a little, you know, it's a little baby that died, and we give our all to all the little babies that died. So, you know, I know there was a lot of media pressure around, but, you know, we want to do a good job in all our cases. And if you watch a TV show, you'll see that. You know, whether it's a homeless guy or whether it's going to be on Nancy Grace, I really don't care. I want to give it our all, and we're going to do the best we can.
And how many cases do you get where you know it's a homicide, but it's homicide of unknown origin? How unusual is that?
That's not that unusual. There's, you know... I think every medical examiner has a few of those. You probably get, a couple every, maybe a handful every few years. It's maybe not every year, but clearly every other year you'll get one or two.
Then it's your job to have to go testify to say, here's what my cause of death is. Have you been able to see where something like that, where it is a homicide of unknown origin, where it's still gone through to a successful prosecution?
Oh, absolutely. There's all across the country. That's happened. That's not that unusual.
So that doesn't...
At least not in my world, it's not that unusual.
Okay, and you have a new morgue opening up next month?
New morgue will start business on October 26th. The grand opening is October 23rd.
And what's the address of it?
That's
somewhere on Michigan.
Question.
I got a new morgue. I just don't know where
it's on the
it is.
Corner of... The new morgue is going to be on the corner of Michigan and Bombay, and I hope nobody has to visit unless they have to.
Anything else you want to talk about on the case you don't want to talk about, Caylee? Nothing.
I there's no point. Let that play out. It really isn't that, it's just one of many cases that we go through our morgue.
Do you get many people asking you about it?
Yes, and I say no, I don't want to talk about it.
Okay. All right. Well, thank you for taking the time.
Oh, you're right.